The fourth and last part of this series of video lectures on elasticity goes into some other elasticities we can look at besides price elasticity of demand. And the first one we're going to look at here is elasticity of supply. And just like elasticity of demand was related to the slope of the demand curve, elasticity of supply is related to the slope of the supply curve. And just as before, when the supply curve is steep, small price changes, or price changes, only cause small changes in quantity supplied, which is another way of saying that sellers are not very price sensitive, or that the quantity sold is relatively inflexible to price changes. And if something's inflexible, we could also call it inelastic. So economists often talk about a situation of inelastic supply if the amount that people are willing to sell is relatively fixed and doesn't change much if you increase or decrease the price. At a formal mathematical level, the elasticity is between 0 and 1. And notice that because price and quantity always move in the same direction on the supply curve, elasticity should always be a positive number if we're talking about elasticity of supply. If the supply curve is fairly flat, if it only slopes upward very gradually, then small price changes cause large changes in quantity supplied. So that's another way of saying that sellers are price sensitive. Or quantity sold is flexible. It can change by a lot. It can stretch. And so it's elastic, and in this situation, elasticity should be greater than 1. So an elasticity of something like 5 tells us that as price goes up by 1%, quantity supplied goes up by something like 5%. An elasticity that's something like 1/3 or 0.33 tells us that if prices go up by something like 9%, quantity demanded only goes up by 1/3 of that, or 3%. I'm sorry, I said quantity demanded, I meant quantity supplied. Okay. So again, we want to go ahead and remember the definition here. The elasticity of one variable with respect to another is the percentage change in the outcome variable over the percentage change in the input variable. And that's going to be something to remember when we look at our next couple of elasticities, which are not as similar to elasticity of demand. Okay. Cross-price elasticity measures the responsiveness of the demand for one good to the price of another. So we're crossing from the quantity demanded of good A to the price of good B. At a formal level, the cross-price elasticity of demand is the percentage change in the quantity demanded of good A over the percentage change in the price of good B. And one of the main applications here is used to measure whether two goods are substitutes or complements, and the strength of the substitute or complement relationship between two goods. And notice that if cross-price elasticity is positive, what we're saying is when the price of one good goes up, people buy more of the second. Because when the price of the B good goes up, people buy less of B and more of A. On the other hand, if we have complements, then cross-price elasticity of demand should be negative. When the price of B goes up, the quantity demanded of A goes down. So we might see something like, when the price of gasoline goes up, the quantity demanded of tires goes down because people buy fewer tires. This actually all sounds kind of obscure, but actual important legal questions get settled based on this. And in particular, as we'll see later, if two firms are considering merging, the Justice Department is going to be kind of skeptical because that might lead to monopoly power. firms that are merging will often argue, oh, we actually have a lot of competitors. So say, for instance, two cable companies are considering merging. They might say, well, yes, it's true that that will give us a larger share of the cable market, but maybe something like Dish is a close substitute for cable, and so you don't have to worry about us becoming a monopoly because Dish will act to keep us competitive. And whether or not that's actually a credible claim or not turns on the magnitude of the cross-price elasticity. For instance, what happens to the demand for Dish services if cable companies raise their rates? If, when cable companies raise their rates, the demand for Dish grows a lot, then we can be relatively confident that consumers are willing to switch to Dish if cable companies start raising their prices. So that tends to make it look like, yes, consumers regard those as substitutes. If, on the other hand, the cross-price elasticity is a relatively small number, then not many consumers go to Dish when cable companies raise their rates. So consumers apparently don't regard them as viable substitutes for each other. Here's several review problems for cross-price elasticity. And as you can see here in this slide and in the next one, another application of cross-price elasticity is dealing with things like loss leaders. So I'll go ahead and let you guys think through that after you pause the video. The last elasticity we're going to talk about here is the income elasticity of demand for a good. More formally, the elasticity of quantity demanded of a good with respect to the consumer's income. Mathematically, this elasticity is the percentage change in quantity demanded over the percentage change in income. We often use this to measure whether a good is a luxury good or a necessity or an inferior good. If elasticity is greater than 1, then if someone's income goes up by 10%, they buy 30% more of this product. So they're, in a sense, biased towards spending a lot more money on this product when their income goes up. So we tend to think of that as a luxury good. If, on the other hand, elasticity is something like 0.3, then when your income goes up by 10%, you only buy a little bit more of this product, 3% more of this product. So that's something that is probably a relatively everyday necessity out there. And last, we can have cases where the income elasticity of demand is negative. So if your income goes up by 10%, maybe you reduce your purchases by 3%. In that case, we're dealing with an inferior good, and the more negative that elasticity, the more inferior the good is. So here's our application problem for this one, and I'll go ahead and let you guys pause the video and look that over.